What other functions does calcium truly have in the body? One is called a, well, it's a hormone signaling molecule known as a secondary messenger. So what does this really mean? Let's dive into this function. This is one of the most critical functions of calcium. Two with a zero above, that's a secondary. That's what that stands for. So it's a hormone secondary messenger. So let me draw you a picture and kind of explain to you what that means. This is a critical function of calcium. So on the surface of your cells, you have hormone receptors that stick out. Okay, so hormone, let's just say in this case estrogen, right, comes in and it binds onto that hormone receptor. We'll call that an HR hormone receptor. That's going to trigger a message to come into the cell. And that message, as it's coming through the cell membrane, calcium picks that message up. Calcium, this is where calcium as a secondary messenger comes in. It picks up the message from the hormone and delivers the message to your DNA, and that's what brings about the effect of hormones. So when we talk about calcium as a hormone messenger, your hormones won't work as well. You'll have a dampened hormone response if you truly have a chronically low level of calcium in your diet, chronic calcium deficiency. So secondary messenger hormonal problems are a common manifestation of calcium deficiency. We'll talk a little bit more about that. But this can happen, and this occurs for pretty much most sex steroids, estrogen, progesterone, testosterone. So remember, and if your calcium levels are too low over time, your hormone message is not going to be stopped. It's not all or none. It's going to be a dampened effect. You're not going to have this communication as well. If you ever played that game in grade school where you whispered something into somebody's ear and then they whispered it to the next person and the next person, and then at the end of the line, right, the message was completely skewed. It typically was not the original message. That would be like having no calcium or very little calcium to deliver the proper message. And so then the right message doesn't make it to the DNA, which doesn't lead to the upregulation of what that hormone is trying to upregulate. So that's a major problem with calcium deficiency. So it works as a hormone secondary messenger. One of the other functions of calcium is it's an electrolyte. Now, it's funny, you never see or hear about calcium as an electrolyte, but it plays a role in nerves and muscle function. So if we're talking about nerves, your nerves have to talk to each other, okay? And in a nerve, well, let's use a different color for you. So if we look at just kind of a general nerve ending, it's called a synaptic bouton in biology. You might have, if you took a biology class, you might have heard this term. But this is nerve A. We'll call this nerve A. We'll call this nerve B. And so this gap in between the nerves, this gap here is called the cleft. And so what has to happen is, if this nerve A is trying to talk to nerve B, then what happens is you've got to have an electrical charge come through this nerve. And that electrical charge in part is provided as a result of potassium and chloride, so sodium and potassium, but also magnesium, which we talked about before. But calcium, what's at the end of this nerve is something called a calcium channel. So when the electrical impulse travels down the nerve, and I didn't draw the whole nerve, but you know, imagine this long wire, right, coming down. And when it hits, when that electrical depolarization hits that calcium channel, calcium floods in to the nerve cell. And it does something to these little, these are called vesicles. And inside these little bubbles, if you will, you store your neurochemicals, things like dopamine and serotonin, right? The nerve chemicals that allow our brain cells to communicate. So calcium floods in and it tells these bubbles of nerve chemical to dump themselves or to release themselves into this gap. And when that happens, you have little receptors on the other side that pick up on these chemicals. And so what that does is it allows this message to pass this gap and to come this way. Now your body does that on purpose. Your body wants to have an off and an on switch for nerves, and basically that's what calcium is. So think of it as a light switch. We can flip open that gate or we can close that gate very, very quickly, and it allows for that nerve to talk or that message to stop. And sometimes we need a message to continue, and sometimes we need to stop a message from happening. And that's, again, that's where calcium deficiency can create hyperexcitable nerves, where a message might not be stopping appropriately, or it can create not enough communication, so the nerve isn't communicating as well. It can go either way, because it depends on whether your body needs that light switch to be off or on for that nerve communication to occur or to not occur. So nerves, very, very important. But one of the other is in muscle contraction. So contractility of muscles, your muscles have to contract, your muscles have to relax. And depending on what you're trying to get them to do, if you don't have adequate calcium, your muscles can actually spasm instead. So again, the message is not quite clear. So you can develop cramping or spasms or muscle tetany. These are very, very common. So these are some of the major, major functions of calcium. You know, most of you have heard of the bone aspect, but very few may have heard of how calcium delivers the message of your hormones and works as kind of a missing electrolyte to help deliver the functionality to your nerves and the functionality to your muscles as well. So, very, very important. Hey, don't forget to check out the rest of the series right here. Make sure you hit subscribe below. And as always, thanks for tuning in.